Parashah of this week, the Parashah of Yitziat Mitzrayim. And we know that it's one of the mitzvot that HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us is to remember always Yitziat Mitzrayim. Whenever you are, day and night, Pesach, Sukkot, Shabbat, Birkat Hamazon, always we have to remember Yitziat Mitzrayim. Always, always, always. When we do Shachrit, we talk about Yitziat Mitzrayim. We do Arvit, we talk about Yitziat Mitzrayim. We go to bed, we talk about Yitziat Mitzrayim. It's something that always we have to talk about. And the question is, why? Why Hashem, He give us this mitzvah of Yitziat Mitzrayim that we have to be connected? Why we have to be always to be connected to that mitzvah and never to forget it? Why? What's exactly what's special on Yitziat Mitzrayim? Rabotai, you have to know one thing. It's only through thinking about Yitziat Mitzrayim and to know what happened to our parents in Egypt, so we can understand that we are not better than them, that we as well, we need our own Yitziat Mitzrayim. Don't think because we live in Miami, we live in America, we have all the material, we have everything, that we are safe. We are slaves. We are slaves of our Yitzhara. So Yitziat Mitzrayim, to remember the Yitziat Mitzrayim that once we were the slaves of Pharaoh. Today we are not the slaves of Pharaoh, but today we are the slaves of ourselves. We are the slaves, we have everything, but we have everything, but we are slaves. We have slaves. Before that Mashiach will come, the prophet said that I will show you more miracles when Mashiach will come, that the miracles that I did in Yitziat Mitzrayim. I would like to think, what kind of miracles can Hashem do to us before, more than the miracles that Hashem did to us when we were in Egypt? I think everyone here will agree with me that what we have been suffering in Egypt, it's more than today. Today, more or less, Baruch Hashem, we're okay. Okay, we have few Shoahs, but now we forgot the Shoah. Look, that tower that was collapsed 5 months ago here in Miami. People today don't think about it. Today already people think how to buy an apartment there. But it was shocking for during 2 months where they were looking for bodies. I remember I was here. People were shocking. What happened? No one could reach that place. And today, people forgot. Look, I was in New York last week. I've been through the Twin Tower that more than 3,000 people killed in 1 minute. Now they build already there few buildings, offices. Nobody thinks there is a souvenir there. There is a plaque, souvenir of the 3,000 people who died here. People don't think about it, that's it. Now, they turn the page. People, a lot of, unfortunately, even my father, Alav Hashem, no, tonight is the Hezgah of my mother. She passed away 3 years ago. I thought I will never stop crying for my mother. I thought my mother, she was the best, and I will never forget my mother. Well, now, 3 years later, it's not I forgot my mother. I don't cry anymore. That's it. She's now Olam HaEmet. That's it. We cried a lot during 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, and after we forgot. Hashem, He don't want us to forget the exit of Egypt. Why? Because Hashem, He knows that a human being, he forget. He passed all the things. But Hashem, He don't want us to forget the Torah. When He talk about Miriam, the Lashon Hara, did she speak? Don't forget what I did to Miriam. Because people, unfortunately, they forget. Unfortunately, they forget when they start to talk Lashon Hara. So it's something that we have to be very, very careful. So that's why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, He gave us some mitzvot. Hakadosh Baruch Hu, He gave us some mitzvot that we will never forget them. Because from those mitzvot, we learn something. Not to talk Lashon Hara, because Lashon Hara is something that we are used to talk Lashon Hara. Hey, don't forget, look what Hashem did to Miriam. Amalek, don't forget Amalek. Amalek, what it is Amalek? Amalek wanted to take our energy from doing the mitzvot with love. Baruch Hashem, we wake up in the morning, we come to the synagogue, we pray. But today, unfortunately, today we come to the synagogue with a business in our mind, and thinking about business in our mind before praying. That means you become already cold when you pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, money, dollar is gematria Amalek. Dollar, if you do a calculation of dollar, it's the same number of Amalek. That means Hashem, don't forget, Amalek is not a human being. Amalek could be dollar. Amalek could be a doubt. Amalek, it could be Deitzara. Don't forget, wherever you are, there is Amalek. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us some mitzvot to remember them, so that we will be a good Jew. That's why Hashem give us the mitzvah of to remember the exit of Egypt more than any mitzvah, more. Because Amalek, we remember Amalek in the morning, but it's at Mitzrayim, it's a mitzvah that we non-stop, in the morning, the Shachrit, Arvit, Because Amazon, 3 times a day, if you eat bread, if you eat 10 times a day, bread, so I have to talk about, because the Itzat Mitzrayim is the base of our emunah. It's the base of our emunah. It's the base of our, it's like energy, it's like a battery. You know, my friend, a car without a battery, it's a dead car. So the emunah of the exit of Egypt, it's our battery. So we always it should be full, always. So the more we talk about it, we feel it more. And my friend, before Mashiach will come, as I told you before, Hashem will show us a lot of miracles, more than the miracles that we saw in Egypt. What kind of miracles? What kind of miracles? Rabotai, can we imagine all the miracles that Hashem did in Egypt? I mean, for us, it's something that we can never forget. But what speciality when Mashiach will come that we will see miracles? You know, my friend, what is not to be called? Because Amalek is getting a lot of space. Amalek, Amalek is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And we are more or less in Amalek. That was Baruch Hashem. The reason why we speak all the time about Yitzhak Mitzrayim is to remember that HaKadosh Baruch Hu help us with miracles to get out from Egypt. But before Mashiach will come, there is another kind of Egypt, but it's not the Egypt of Paro, it's the Egypt of Amalek. It's the Egypt of unfortunately, to forget that there is Mashiach, that there is something that... So HaKadosh Baruch Hu, He will show us things that we connect us with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I would like to finish. A few days ago, I was talking about the exit of Egypt, and then I started to talk about Mashiach, that when Mashiach will come, Hashem, He show us more miracles. For Egypt, the Mashiach of that time was Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe and Aaron. But with Hashem, when Mashiach will come, we will have Mashiach ben David, Mashiach ben Yosef, but Mashiach ben David is the most important. So I was talking about that, and there was a woman, she started laughing. Bemeta, I said, why you laugh? She said, you talk about Mashiach, or people talking about, but what do we need Mashiach for? Can you tell me, Rabbi, we have everything. What Mashiach can bring me? And then suddenly, all the people that they were at the table, that they were listening, and suddenly they agree with her. Yes, she's right. What can Mashiach can bring us? Yeah. So then I was a little bit, I did not know to who to answer. Suddenly, you know what I told them? Exactly what the Rambam said. The Rambam said, when Mashiach will come, he will not bring us any speciality. He will not make miracles. What he will bring is that he will show us that there is Hashem. Olam kimin hagon noheg. The world will remain as it is. There will be planes, private planes, cars, business, everything will remain. But what he will bring us, Mashiach, he will bring us that there is Hashem. There is no Amalek anymore. There is no doubt anymore. That it will be the speciality of Mashiach. That's what Hashem did to the Bnei Israel in Egypt. Because they forgot there is Hashem. So what Hashem did, he did a lot of miracles so that the people, we know there is Hashem. Exactly. Because don't forget, the Bnei Israel, they were at a low level of on Tumah. They were Memtet Sha'ari Tumah. They were at a very low level. They were disconnected completely from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So Hashem, he had to do some experience with them. He had to do a demonstration that he's the boss, he's the king, he's Hashem, he's the Baal HaBayit, he's the one, it's not Paro anymore, he's the one created. So Hashem, Yida'atem ki ani Hashem. So all what Hashem did, it's just that the place we know there is Hashem. Exactly that's what Hashem is going to bring Mashiach for. That we will know that this, we live in Olam HaShekher, and now we have to renew the world to be like it was before Adam HaRishon did the Avera. What? That Hashem Emet, V'Torato Emet. That's what he will bring. So, more or less they accepted. Because they thought that Mashiach will take their money, they will take their plane, they will take a... No, he will not take nothing that belongs to you. The contrary, he will give you more. But all what you will know, that you will not ask questions like that. That you have a full emunah on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is what we are waiting for. Shti Shmatima Tzura B'Gan Eden Amen. Amen. Rabbi Shomer HaKadosh Baruch Hu.